In this video, we'll learn to take the derivative of a power function. Unlike the derivative of a constant function, or the derivative of a linear function, I think it would be very hard to come up with this rule by thinking about it. So I'll just tell you what the rule is. When you have the derivative of x raised to a power, that brings the power down in front of the x. And then in the exponent, we subtract 1. For example, the derivative of x to the fifth, the 5 comes down in front of the x. And in the power, we subtract 1. It's 5x to the 4th. The derivative of x to the -3.7. Obviously, an uglier power than 5, but the rule works exactly the same, that -3.7 comes down in front of the x, and in the power, we subtract 1. Giving us a power of -4.7. Let's look at another kind of special example. Let's differentiate the square root of x. You might object that the square root of x is not a power function. It actually is, though. It's x to the 1/2 power. In general, the nth root of x is x to the 1/n. So we can differentiate this using the power rule. The 1/2 comes down. In the power, we subtract 1. So 1/2 times x to the -1/2. And that's the derivative. We could rewrite this a little if we wanted to. Having a negative power is the same as having a positive power in the denominator of a fraction. And then x to the 1/2 is the square root of x. Speaking of going from here to here and back again, let's do one more example. Let's differentiate 1/7. We can do this if we remember the rule we use to go from here to here, except in reverse, having a positive power in the denominator is the same as having a negative power. And now this is a straightforward application. The -7 comes down. In the power, we subtract 1. So -7 times x to the -8. And if we wanted to rewrite this a little, we could, using the same rule we used to go from here to here. And for that matter, the same rule we used to go from here to here. A negative power is the same as a positive power in the denominator. And we could then do this multiplication, -7/8. And that's the power rule. We're going to use this probably every single week in calculus one. And then we're going to keep right on using it in calculus two. Do not waste any time. Do not lose any time mastering this material.